Taurus, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to do your reading for the month of July for Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs. And this is a general reading, it might or might not resonate with all of you. And if you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification icon as well so that you will be notified about my latest videos. Okay? So I'll be looking at some of your past energies, your present and future energies. Then I'll end up my reading with some couple of cards from the universe. Okay, now let's get started with your reading now. And let's see what are the July predictions for you, for my Taurus. Taurus, July 2020. The overall energy is Knight of Cups. I feel that there is some kind of passionate, some kind of romantic side of yours which you are feeling now, and you just, because there are many things in your life, there are many things going on, so sometimes you want something, sometimes you want the other thing. For some people, I feel that this is a romantic side of yours which you want to explore, but you always end up with those people who don't even, you know, respect you, who don't even care about you. You end up with those people. They do not accept the love which you are offering towards them, because you are like, okay, I want the stable beginning with you and I want you to be in my life forever. And you just want to be a very happy married life you want with these people. But at the end, they just go away and they just show their exact faces and they leave you. Okay. For some people, I feel that you have to make a lot of choices with regards to your work as well, because the work which you love, it's more like, it's not actually, the work doesn't love you back sometimes. So you just want some things, you are feeling left out as well, I feel. Okay, so your past energies are the Lovers, Five of Pentacles and Ace of Cups. You have made some choice in your past, I feel, with some kind of love relationship, because it was a very beautiful new relationship and an offer of love which you felt that it will last long, but at the end you just, that person left you out, and, you know, alone. Or you might be the person who chose this thing to happen because it was not giving you enough stability, enough, you know, sometimes it becomes very toxic and some people do not accept the love offer which you are giving. So you have to make some choice sometimes. So I feel that you made some choice regarding this. In your present, Four of Rods, Five of Swords and Four of Cups, I feel you are going through some kind of pressure, some kind of problems in your family, some kind of toxic relationships as well, I feel, for some people. And you are not able to accept this kind of relationship because you just want respect from your partner. You want respect in your work as well. So that is why you are feeling very bad, feeling very horrified in your work as well. And you just want respect, and that is not actually, the people are not giving you, they are very gossiping, they are very bad towards you. Okay, the future cards are Ace of Rods, Nine of Cups and Seven of Pentacles. The future over here is telling me that you are actually, you know, you have just left this journey, this every time love, stability, love, being determined in so much of passionate love and everything, you start giving everything to everyone but you didn't get anything back. So I feel that you are going towards this new journey of yours, and where you will be the free bird, the way you want to live your life. and you will be you are showing so much of gratitude towards this new things, because sometimes, you know, self care, I feel that self love is giving you so much of love that nobody else can give you. So let's clarify now the cards. Let's clarify Knight of Cups. Two of Swords and Three of Rods. Yes. So you are feeling left out. Might be some issues in your work as well, because your savings are over. So you are waiting for your new offer, new joining letter to come really fast, and you are not able to decide because the bank balance is actually coming to an end, and you have no other choice left. Okay, for some people. For some people, I feel that there are might be a long distance relationship, and that person is not contacting you, and you are feeling okay, what's going on with this person, and you don't even know, because that you are feeling left out because of that ignorance, and you are waiting for their messages, for their calls, for communication to happen, and that is not happening. That is making you very restless, and it is actually bringing a lot of confusion. You might be dealing with a Libra as well, so you are like, what's going on with my Libra, or what's going on with my new person? Why is he or she not replying me? So you are finding something fishy over here. Okay, yeah, that's it. Okay, so let's clarify the Lovers. Lovers with the Devil, Three of Pentacles and Nine of Cups. Okay, so for you it was a decision which was made because actually you thought that this is not love. It might be lust only. It might be some kind of attraction, addiction towards some person. So with the Devil, Three of Pentacles and Nine of Cups, you were feeling that you took this decision because you were feeling that this is not going to be a long-term relationship. You actually worked a lot in this situation, and you tried to figure it out because it might be a third-party situation as well. Might be a third person be involved because here as well, I see Three of Wands and Two of Swords, that you were waiting for this person's message and call, but this person might be involved somewhere else, and you thought that okay, so this is not exactly the love from them, their side as well. You just find out that this was just some kind of attraction, and you took a decision, and you followed, you just accepted that being alone is much better than being in this kind of a relationship. So you took this step. Okay, so let's clarify Ace of Cups. Seven of Pentacles, Eight of Cups, and Four of Swords. Let's see. You gave time to this person because you actually felt a lot of love, and you gave time. You still thought a lot about the situation because see the way this person is sleeping and he is thinking, might be dreaming as well, the dreams coming about this person, that what is he or she doing over there, she is not near me, he or she is so far away from me, so what might be, she's not picking up my call, might be something else going on as well. So you gave a lot of time, you had patience as well, but finally you took the step of moving away from the situation because it didn't give you enough stability the way you want, the way my Taurus wants. And Taurus are always very determined towards one thing. If they want a happy family, they will just go towards this family, and you just want that I will be with this person forever my life. Let's clarify. What do we need to clarify? Let's clarify. Of the Five of Swords. Oh my god, Five of Swords, Six of Swords, Seven of Swords with the Magician. Okay, one more card is there. Page of Swords. Okay, so a lot of toxicity in this relationship, Taurus, a lot. And if you chose this decision, it was really good then, because it's like with the Five of Swords, Six of Swords, after Five of Swords, you took a decision and you took a step that moving away is much better than just staying in this kind of a relationship. Then after that Seven of Swords, you found out that the other person actually cheated on you, because I really feel that there is third party situation over here, and you were not happy because you might have stalked this person, you might have checked the emails or some messages, and you found out the truth with the Page of Swords. This generally is the stalker card of the deck, and he just, the online stuff and all, you found out that something is fishy. And with the Magician as well, you did some things which might not be legal, but illegally you caught this person that, no. And you finally accepted that, fine, this is the thing, and you are not, might be this person is coming towards you again and you not accepted them. Let's see what is this Four of Cups telling. Okay, so you are in a state with the cards are Queen of Cups, Temperance and the Hanged Man. You are in a state where you want perfect balance, perfect harmony, and you actually found out, you felt really emotional, you might have cried a lot, and but might be a Cancer you are dealing with, might be a Sagittarius as well, but you were like, fine, I cannot accept this kind of thing, and you finally stopped talking to them and you went into deep inner healing. I feel that. So you are thinking the love story or whatever situation is from a different perspective. Okay? Let's see what's the Ace of Rods telling us in your future energy. Sorry for that. Seven of Pentacles. Sorry, Eight of Pentacles. Eight of Swords and the Tower. Okay. So in your future, I see a drastic change in your life. Sudden incident is going to happen. Might be you are getting some kind of new job or something, or your work, whatever your work is, your self-love, if you're a businessman, you are working. I see you working towards with this Ace of Rods and with this Eight of Pentacles. I see you that you are so much busy in working. See the man, how the way he is working, he is just looking towards his coins and he is so busy working. So that is what you are doing. I see in your future you might not even have time to see other stuff in your life. So that is why this drastic change is coming towards you in your future, and it is going to be very sudden. You might even forget everything, and you are actually happy with this thing. Let's try for Nine of Cups. Judgment, yes. It's something you are actually celebrating about something. You might be you might become so rich in this particular time that you are actually going towards a very stable beginning, because with the Ace of Rods over here and Ace of Pentacles also in your future, you have a very passionate and stable beginning. You are working towards that thing, and that will take you to greater heights as well. And you are really happy. With the Judgment card, it is telling you that your bad days are over, Taurus, and whatever you wanted, it is coming towards you. So just stay calm. Okay? Let's clarify the Seven of Pentacles. I don't think Seven of Pentacles need to be clarified, because it's just telling me that you have sown your seeds and you are ready. Whenever the seeds will be ripened, whenever your fruits will be ripened, you will get that offer, that award, that reward which you are waiting for. And this is very much clear from your future cards. Let's see what the universe has to tell you. Reading, so it means a lot of inner healing is still there, which needs to happen. Okay, so just do not jump into any conclusions. Always do not jump into some new relationships, Taurus. If you are feeling that you need some clarity, so just wait, halt over there, think the things from a different perspective, take some time, find your inner balance and peace, and then you will be rewarded with the Ace of Pentacles, and you will have that proper beginning, that stable beginning which you want. Okay, so the cards, the universe is telling us Ace of Swords, the Fool and Temperance. So the Fool, there is a new journey awaiting for you, and you are just clear the clouds, clear everything, because see the tower, it's like just you have to clear. See when sudden thing happens, let's say an earthquake happens. So what happens with that? A lot of smoke. See over here, the fire is there, thunder is there. So what will happen? The tower will fall, and after falling, people will also fall. And what will happen after that? After some time, you will see the air is getting clearer. So the universe is telling you that just wait, let the things will be clear, and let just see yourself after that. If there is some kind of communication which you want with someone, So the universe is telling you, you can go ahead and just solve that conversation, solve that problem with communication problem if you are having, and balance everything out. Okay, so just do not make grudges, do not take some things, whatever bad or good people you might feel, just go on, clarify the things and then move on with your life. Because with the Fool card, I see you going towards new things, but do not jump into any conclusion without analyzing the depth of that situation, and find proper balance, peace and harmony in every situation, because for that you have to be balanced within yourself as well. Alright, so I hope you like my reading, Taurus. That's all from my side, and we'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.